Good morning, Life Center. It's a pleasure to be with you again for a time of prayer. One of the greatest promises that we have as children of God is the promise of the gift of the Holy Spirit. The Bible tells us in Joel 2:28-29, and then in Acts 17:2-27, the same scripture quoted by Apostle Peter the following. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. So the promise of the Holy Spirit is for everyone, men, women, young and old, everyone. Jesus told his disciples that it was for our benefit, for our advantage that he will go away. Because if he didn't go away, the helper, the advocate, the comforted will not come. But if he go, he will send him to us. So what a great gift. He encouraged his disciples also to ask the Father for the gift of the Holy Spirit. He said in Luke 11:13, If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more your Father in heaven will give the Holy Spirit to those who ask for him. So we need to ask for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Before he ascended to heaven, he commanded his disciples saying, Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father has promised, which you have heard me talk about. John baptizes with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. What a great gift. As parents, we know that the last instructions we give to our children when we are going away are crucial for their well-being while we are absent. So Jesus knew that the disciples, that we will need the Holy Spirit to accomplish everything that he had called us to do. So we ask for the Holy Spirit, and we know that on Pentecost, when the Spirit fell on the disciples, something happened. And that's what Jesus was trying to tell them. He said, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes to you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the world. And we could see it. Peter was one who had denied Jesus. He had been hiding after his crucifixion because he had fear. But when he received the Holy Spirit, he was bold enough to preach to the multitudes. And in one day, 3,000 people was added to the church. So as we prepare for Pentecost, we know that God is ready to pour out his Spirit in his church as never before. Let's ask the Father for the power of the Holy Spirit to be baptized with his Spirit and fire. Let's pray. Father, we ask today that you will pour out your Spirit on all flesh, that your promise will be fulfilled in our lives, God. We ask for a fresh baptism of your Holy Spirit and fire. Thank you for the promise. We receive it today in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you and have a great day.